welcome to this introduction to MicroTonic, the synthetic rhythm generator plugin from Sonic Charge. I'm going to take you on a quick tour around the user interface and show you the main features. Let's start at the top of the panel with the global preset management. Clicking this reveals a long list of presets to choose from. And you can also scroll through the list using the buttons either side. Clicking above and to the left reveals a drop-down list with 16 preset slots. I can queue up a different preset in each of these. And if I then enable MIDI program changes from the same menu, I can use program change messages to switch between those 16 presets. The main menu to the left allows us to save presets and also provides other useful options such as randomize all or alter drum patches to automatically create subtle variations of your sounds. Above this we find a scripts menu with a range of more advanced functions. For example, we could duplicate a single drum sound across all 8 channels and automatically tune them to a specific scale. Or we could halve the current pattern speed. Or we can even automatically generate preset names. These functions are not hard-coded into MicroTonic and are instead created using a special scripting language, so advanced users can potentially create their own. 8 drum channels are provided, which we can switch between using the buttons along the top. These are all identical, so there are no restrictions on how many kick drums or snares you can set up. But the factory presets all follow broadly the same convention, with bass drums on channel 1 and snares on channel 5. We can verify this by muting channels, or by holding Control or Command while pressing the mute button, which will solo the channel instead. So let's click the channel 5 button to select our snare sound. Then click the smaller preset field underneath to reveal a long list of alternate snare presets. And again, I can use the arrows either side to scroll through the other presets in that directory. If I select Browse for drum patches, I can select a different category, such as percussion patches, for example. And I can now use the arrows to scroll through a range of percussion sounds instead. These sounds are all entirely synthesized, and the parameters have been carefully tuned to make it quick and easy to dial in the sound you want. In the middle, we have an oversampled oscillator with a choice of 3 waveforms, and a slider to set the bass frequency. The slider setting is also displayed as a MIDI note number, so it's easy to tune your drums to the key of the song if needed. The vertical sliders control the amp envelope, so I can use the decay to control the length of the note. And if I hold Shift, I can fine-tune the attack time to control the clicks at the start. 3 different types of pitch modulation are available. The default envelope setting can create classic analog-style bass drum or tom sounds, while the frequency modulation mode can create inharmonic metallic-sounding waveforms. And the third mode modulates the oscillator using a filtered noise source, with the rate knob now controlling the smoothing filter. Turn this up to create bursts of noise for snare drum type sounds. The noise section to the right has another 2-stage amp envelope, this time with a choice of shapes. The exponential shape is the same as the oscillator envelope and produces a natural sounding decay and an interesting reverse effect with longer attack times. While the linear mode can produce gated reverb type effects or soft shakers. And the final setting features a special type of multi-triggering attack stage, specifically designed to create clap sounds. We can shape the noise using a resonant filter with a choice of low pass, band pass, or high pass types. And the filter frequency is again displayed as a MIDI note, as well as a value in Hertz. If I turn the Q knob up past about the halfway point, the filter will start to ring at the specified pitch. As a bonus, I can turn on the stereo knob to switch to using separate noise sources for the left and right channels, which can create interesting pseudo-stereo effects. Over to the left, we can blend the oscillator and noise sections using the mix slider, add distortion, and shape the results with the single band EQ. With 40 dB of gain range available, this can create steep notches or dramatic peaking boosts. I could then route this sound to the B output pair to process it with external effects. But if you're using the multi-output version of MicroTonic, each channel will already be hardwired to its own independent output pair. The sound morph slider at the top is new in version 3. This interpolates all the synth controls for all channels between two different stored settings. So you could create subtle variations of your sounds. Or you could morph them into something completely different. As with all the front panel controls, this setting can be automated from the host. And if you right-click, you can learn a MIDI controller. Switching drum channels also switches the sequencer section below to show the lane for that drum. You can get an overview of the whole pattern by opening the matrix editor to the right. And the selected drum channel will then follow the last lane you touch, so you can easily add accents or fills. The beat division for each step can be changed using the slider below, so you can double the pattern speed, or halve it, or create triplet polyrhythm. And you can dial in a swing feel with the slider to the right. 12 different patterns are available, which we can switch between using the buttons marked A to L over to the left. Notice that the pattern doesn't actually change till the next bar start. Patterns have 16 steps, but you can set shorter pattern lengths by clicking the small row of buttons at the bottom. Or you can chain patterns together to create longer sequences. We can also switch between patterns using MIDI notes. And in a similar way, we can start or stop the internal sequencer, or mute individual drum channels. If I right-click any control and choose Edit MIDI Controller and Keys, I can change the notes assigned to each function. And I can quickly edit or learn MIDI controller assignments for all the panel controls. The sequencer section of MicroTonic actually transmits MIDI note data, as well as triggering its internal synths. So you can route this MIDI to other synths or samplers to drive their sounds from MicroTonic's patterns. Alternatively, I could disable the internal sequencer by pressing the stop button and trigger the synth sounds via MIDI instead. And if I click the MIDI drag icon at the bottom left and drag it to the relevant track in my host, the current pattern will be converted into a MIDI clip for further editing. The keyboard icon at the top of the interface denotes pitched MIDI mode. With this enabled, MicroTonic can be played chromatically like a conventional synth. If I also turn on the button to the right, MicroTonic will respond to note off data, so each note will end as soon as I release the key. Okay, I'm going to finish off back where I started and click the main preset field again. At the top of the list, we find an option to browse your hard drives for more presets. But if you have an internet connection, you also have the option to browse the Patternarium instead. This is much more than just an online collection of presets. Patternarium is an ongoing experiment in evolutionary sound design, in which each new generation of presets is created by breeding from the previous generation. Here we see patterns from the 11th generation. We can browse through the list using the next and previous buttons. And we can vote each pattern up or down, and thereby influence how likely it is to breed into the next generation. if you open the information tab at the top right. You can even look back through the generations and listen to this pattern's parents or grandparents. If you find a preset you want to use, you can save via the button at the top left. Or you can copy it to your clipboard and paste it directly into MicroTonic. That's all I've got time for in this video. I've only been able to scratch the surface of most of the features, but if you need more information, you can launch a detailed user manual by opening the main menu and choosing Help. Thanks for watching.